adverse impact on the overall M&A scenario in the country. If you talk of numbers, last year Q1 FY20, the transactions used to be average 200 transactions every quarter. But if you look at this year, the first quarter, there were only 109 M&A transactions. If you look at PEVC space also, if you take out the Reliance Jio transaction, then last year, first quarter, there were $5.3 billion of private equity transactions, compared to only $2.3 billion private equity transactions in the first quarter of this financial year. Which is very clear that people are sitting on cash, people do not want to take decisions in these uncertain times. We do a lot of work with Japan, and I think cross-border transactions are even severely impacted. The reason is very simple, because of travel restrictions. You can't expect companies sitting in Japan or US to take decisions based on Zoom calls or Microsoft Teams. There has to be a site visit, there has to be a lot of interaction which is involved in an M&A transaction. Having said that, I think I personally feel that next quarter two or quarter three, the deal making scenario should improve. The valuation should become reasonable. There will be consolidation opportunities available. Some sectors like pharma, IT, education, online educations are going to see an uptick, and good deals will be available for taking in terms of consolidation.